We're asked to select all of the expressions that are equivalent to negative 8, which means if we simplify the expression, it would be equal to negative 8. So let's take a look at each expression. First, we have 8 raised to the power of negative 1. Notice how this is not 8 times negative 1. Again, it's 8 raised to the power of negative 1. So if we look at the exponent rule given here on the right, a raised to the power of negative m equals 1 over a raised to the power of positive m. One way to remember this rule is to write a to the negative m as a fraction with a denominator of 1. And then if we move a to the negative m down to the denominator, it changes the sign of the exponent. Again, a to the negative m is equal to 1 over a raised to the power of positive m. So applying this rule to 8 raised to the power of negative 1, let's first write this as a fraction with a denominator of 1. And now if we move 8 to the power of negative 1 down to the denominator, it changes the sign of the exponent, and therefore this is equal to 1 over 8 raised to the power of positive 1, which would just be 1 over 8, or 1 eighth. So because 1 eighth does not equal negative 8, this first expression is not equivalent to negative 8. Next we have 8 times negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1. Now there's a couple ways of simplifying this expression. Notice how this product contains 1, 2, 3 negatives. Whenever a product has an odd number of negatives, the product will always be negative. If a product contains an even number of negatives, the product will always be positive. So because we have 3 negatives, which is odd, this product is going to be equal to negative 8. But we can also just multiply from left to right using our rules for multiplying sign numbers, shown here. Where the product of two numbers with the same sign is always going to be positive, and the product of two numbers with different signs is always going to be negative. So if we multiply from left to right, 8 times negative 1 would be negative 8. So we'd have negative 8 times negative 1 times negative 1. Next we would have negative 8 times negative 1, which is positive 8. So we have positive 8 times negative 1. And then we have 8 times negative 1, which is negative 8. So whichever method we use to simplify this, the given expression is equivalent to negative 8 because the expression is equal to negative 8. Next we have 5 times negative 8 fifths. Because we're multiplying by a fraction, let's write 5 as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Now before we multiply fractions, we can always simplify out the common factors between the numerators and denominators. Notice here we have a common factor of 5, and therefore we can simplify. There's 1, 5, and 5, and again 1, 5, and 5. And the reason these are simplifying to 1s is because if we take a look at this separately, 5 over 5 is equal to 1 over 1. But this is just how we show it when multiplying fractions. And now we can multiply knowing the product will be in simplest form. So multiplying the numerators, we have 1 times negative 8, which is negative 8. Multiplying the denominators, we just have 1 times 1, which equals 1, which does simplify to negative 8, which means 5 times negative 8 fifths is equivalent to negative 8. Next we have negative 8 times negative 1. Well, negative times a negative is positive, and therefore negative 8 times negative 1 is equal to positive 8, which is not equal to negative 8, so this expression is not equivalent to negative 8. And for our last expression, we have 8 times 8 divided by negative 8. Following the order of operations, multiplication and division have the same priority, so we multiply and divide from left to right. So 8 times 8 is equal to 64. So we have 64 divided by negative 8. The sign rules for division are the same as the sign rules for multiplication. So a positive divided by a negative is negative, and therefore 64 divided by negative 8 is negative 8, which means this last expression is equivalent to negative 8. I hope you found this helpful.